My name's Tony Preston, and in this first video, we're going to take a brief look at the key features of Agilent's FieldFox microwave analyzers. For a closer look at each of these capabilities, please be sure to watch the other videos in this series, where we take a far more detailed look at each. Agilent's FieldFox microwave analyzer can be ordered as a standalone spectrum analyzer, a standalone network analyzer, or the combo analyzer I have here, which has every option installed. In its basic configuration, it's a sophisticated cable and antenna tester for distance to fault measurements on cables, single port cable loss, as well as making accurate measurements of antenna VSWR and return loss. There's an extremely high performance spectrum analyzer with amplitude accuracy comparable to many benchtop units, and phase noise and third order intermodulation performance far exceeding what you'd expect in a handheld instrument. The spectrum analyzer even tunes down to 5 kHz, so it covers everything from VLF right through to the microwave bands. There's even an interference analyzer option for long-term logging and recording of spectrum traces along with time, date, and GPS position using the internal GPS receiver, ideal for identifying infrequent, illegal, or unknown transmissions, satellite, radar, and jamming signals, or even for spectrum management surveys to identify vacant sections of the RF spectrum. The optional tracking generator can be used to sweep filters and antennas, and can even be used as a CW source, ideal if you need a basic RF siggen out in the field, or to quickly generate a simple fixed frequency beacon signal. With the network analyzer option, you get a full 2-port vector network analyzer with full 12-term error correction. It has outstanding performance, both phase and amplitude accuracy, performance you'd normally only expect from a benchtop instrument. You can measure insertion loss, return loss, phase, group delay, impedance, and Smith chart of all 4 S parameters. And the VNA measures right down to 100 kHz, so you can sweep everything from aircraft NDBs, AM and FM broadcast bands, land and marine mobile, right through Wi-Fi and the cellular phone bands, through to GPS, satellite, radar, and microwave backhaul links. You can even order the time domain option with time domain gating, just like on your benchtop VNA. And best of all, there's a built-in variable DC source that allows you to power up a satellite LNB, a low noise amplifier, a bias tee, or just use it as a handy DC source that's always with you while out on site. There's a highly accurate built-in power meter option available. With this, you can measure the output power of your RF and microwave transmitters without the need for an external power sensor. And unlike a normal broadband power meter and sensor, the power meter in the FieldFox lets you set a bandwidth within which we want to measure the RF power. So we can selectively measure the amplitude of a carrier, even a modulated carrier, extremely accurately, even if other signals are present. Plus, of course, you can still plug in one of Agilent's U2000 series USB microwave power sensors if you prefer. There's even a vector voltmeter option, just like the old HP 8508A you may be familiar with. The vector voltmeter allows us to accurately phase trim RF cables and feed lines, perfect for the installation and maintenance of phased array radar and direction finding antenna systems. The microwave FieldFox is available in 6 frequency ranges, right up to 26.5 GHz. The RF connectors are Type N on all models, except for the 26.5 GHz model I'm using here, which of course has APC 3.5 mm connectors, as Type N connectors go modal above 18 GHz. All of the FieldFox's specifications are guaranteed from minus 10 degrees to plus 55 degrees centigrade, and unlike other handhelds, the FieldFox has no vent holes or fans, minimizing the ingress of dust or moisture. It meets all the relevant mil standard environmental specifications, the relevant explosive atmosphere standards, and it's extremely rugged. As you can see here at Agilent's test site, it's designed to survive multiple drops on every face and all 4 corners, and it's even backed by a 3-year Agilent warranty as standard. Its bright, transflective and backlit TFT display means it can be used in any lighting conditions, direct sunlight and in the dark. It even has predefined screen settings you can quickly select that suit the most common ambient lighting situations. It's got two USB sockets for external data storage and a mini USB port for remote control from a PC. There's a built-in SD card slot, so you can still perform long-term storage even with the weatherproof flaps closed. A time-based reference output and trigger out port, and a 25 MHz spectrum analyzer IF output for wideband signal analysis. There's an Ethernet port for remote control over a local area network and Skippy programming, and an easily replaceable lithium-ion battery. There's a DC input jack for powering and recharging the instrument from the mains or from a vehicle cigarette lighter socket. Here's the variable DC output for powering an LNB, LNA or a BIOS T. Plus, there's a standard headphone output jack. The RF connector on the right is the spectrum analyzer input and port 2 for network analyzer measurements. It's a Type-N connector on all models except the 26.5 GHz unit I have here, which has an SMA-compatible APC 3.5mm connector, as I mentioned earlier. The RF connector on the left is the output for the tracking generator and CW SIGGEN when in spectrum analyzer mode, plus it's port 1 when in network analyzer mode. An external GPS antenna can be plugged into this port here, and there's a time-based reference input and trigger-in connector here. Most importantly, the connector bay on the FieldFox is specifically designed to provide excellent protection to the input connectors if dropped. The front panel buttons are large and easy to use, even when wearing gloves. And best of all, thanks to an extremely low power consumption sleep mode, the FieldFox turns on almost instantly with exactly the same settings you were using last. A great time saver when out in the field. For a more detailed look at the features we've covered here, please watch the other videos in this series where we go through everything in far more detail. And for further information on Agilent's FieldFox microwave analyzers, please contact your local representative or visit the website shown below.